Join Dr. Janet Newell as she shares up close and personal what Yah put on her heart. We are joining this broadcast already in progress.
We must refocus our mindsets. We must refocus our thoughts. We must refocus what's in our heart and what we pay attention to. And the reason why I'm saying that, because a lot of people are distracted by things that are being said about them, that are being done to them, versus what Most High is doing in them, and just recognizing that He is maturing you in the midst of the attack. He is empowering you in the midst of the attack, and He's educating you, and He's giving you some things that you can share with other people that you see go through the same things that you have gone through. You know, we are supposed to encourage one another with the words that we were encouraged with. We are supposed to provoke one another to good work. But if everybody is looking at what the enemy is doing, then think about it. If you're looking at what the enemy is doing, how could you possibly be encouraged by what Yah is doing? So I just want to encourage you tonight and tell you, just begin to praise Yah in the midst of tribulation. Praise Yah in the midst of the attack. Praise Yah, because you're not in there by yourself. You're not in that furnace by yourself. You're not in that lion's den by yourself. You're not in that olive press by yourself. He's there with you. He's there with you to make sure and ensure that you come out safely, that you come out better and not bitter. He's there with you to make sure that after you go through the process, you'll come out established, strengthened, settled, and perfected. He's in that place with you, and He wants you to see Him. He wants you to see His hand moving in every area of your life, no matter what is going on in your life, no matter what state you find yourself in. Most High wants you to see Him in that area. He wants you to come to Him. He wants you to praise Him. The scripture says, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of Yah Mashiach Yahushua concerning you. So everything means everything. No matter what's going on in your life, He wants you to give Him thanks. He wants you to give Him praise. Why? Because in the midst of your praise, He manifests Himself. In the midst of your praise, He shows up. In the midst of your praise, He begins to release, hallelujah, His heavenly host to go and fight on your behalf. He said, be still and know that He is Yah. Be still and know that He will keep you. Be still and know that He will give you the victory. Be still and know that He will strengthen you. Be still and know that He will bring you out. This is a time and a season where we have to make sure that we are looking and we are watching and we are focusing on the right one. This is a time and a season that we must make sure that we're not distracted by what the enemy is doing in our peripheral view and on the sidelines. This is a time and season that we must remain focused on the movement of the Most High Yah and what Yah is doing. It is so important, because the enemy is out there and he's doing all kinds of things. And people are discouraged, but these are people of Yah that's discouraged. But they shouldn't be discouraged if they really know who Yah is. Good evening, my beloved niece, Keisha Gibson. Good evening to you. They should not be discouraged if they really know who Yah is. When we really know who Yah is, even in the toughest times, we continue to seek His face. We continue to praise Him. We continue to trust Him. When we really know who He is, no matter what come our way, we know that there is another side of this suffering. There is another side of this attack. There is another side of whatever is going on in our life that is going to make us come out the head and not the tail. Remember, that's who you are. You're the head and not the tail. You're not the tail. You're the head. And the Most High will make sure that you know that. That's how faithful He is. That's how faithful He is. That's how we should be trusting Him and believing Him no matter what we see. Because He's more real than the situation. And He has everything under control. Just know that He knows and He sees all. There's nothing hidden from the Word. Amen? There's nothing hidden from the Word. And because of that, because we know that, Yah bless you, Apostle Andrew Rollison. Because we know, Trachidia Newby Hall, that the Most High is with us. When others are looking at us and they're wondering, how can you be at peace when all this stuff is going on around you? How can you still be focused? I mean, you still want to serve the Most High and He let this happen to you? They don't understand the Yah that we serve. Listen, we got benefits. I preached that on Saturday. Prophetess Grace preached a phenomenal word as well. But we have benefits with the Most High. We have benefits. We have a right to have an expectation that Yah is going to bring us out. We have a right to have an expectation that we are going to get the victory. Why? Because the word continuously let us know that we will get the victory. The word continuously let us know that we're in covenant with the Yah, the creator of the heaven and earth, that promised that he would protect us and keep us, that promised us that he would not suffer our soul to see corruption, that promised us that he would fight the battle for us. Hallelujah. We're in covenant with the one who has the benefits. And because we're in covenant and covered by the one with the benefits, those benefits kick into gear when we need them. What kind of benefits are we talking about? We're talking about those benefits in the word that says, greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. We're talking about the benefits that says that David said he never saw the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. We're talking about benefits. We're talking about, he said, what should I render unto Yah for all these benefits unto me? What should I return to him? What should I give to him for all of his bountiful blessings unto me? And I stay in that place because we should be people who are grateful, because if he gave us what we really deserved, we would be dealing with wrath every single day of our life. Hallelujah. But he gives us grace and mercy when he should give us wrath and chastisement at times. And that's why we should be really be grateful. We should recognize and understand that those benefits that are promised to us, hallelujah, these benefits do not wear out. These benefits do not expire. And that's great. You know how you work a job and you get, excuse me, my nose is itching. You know how you work a job and you get benefits and they say, well, these benefits are only for 2 months. These benefits are only for 2 years. Those benefits expire, but those benefits that we have with the Most High, y'all, those benefits do not expire. And a lot of people do not call in those benefits. They begin to complain. They begin to murmur. They begin to get afraid. They begin to forget about the benefits that the Most High promised us, that the Most High said he would do for his people, that the Most High has given his word on. We know, just like springtime and harvest, just like you plant a seed and after a season that seed pops up and bring forth fruit. Most High's word is going to bring forth fruit in your life. Hallelujah. Praise Yah, cuz Corey Burns. Praise Yah. Yah be glorified. Hallelujah. Thank you for coming in. Praise Yah, my beloved sister Gwendolyn Pope. Thank you for coming in. I just want to encourage you all tonight. We're losing people. People are sick. Families are breaking up. People are without hope. But when you have the Most High in your life, that's your hope of glory. That's your hope. That's your strength. That's what gives you the ability to stand in the most trying times, because you know what he said in his word. Because you know you have what? You have benefits. So if I can encourage you today with that word, that you have benefits, and it's time for you to call in your benefits. It's time for you to put a call in. It's time for you to tug on the hem of his garments. It's time for you to try him. He said, try ye me. He said, it will work, and who will let it? So I'm telling you, it's time for you to let the word work for you. It's time for you to stop doubting and vacillating back and forth and wondering when is he going to do it, or if he even is going to do it. I'm here to tell you that Yah is going to do whatever he said. It may not be in your timing, but it will come to pass in your lifetime. And so while you're waiting for it to come to pass, you need to occupy until it happens. You need to occupy until it's time. You need to be busy about the things of Yah until that manifestation of that prophetic word that was spoken of your life come to pass. You need to stand on your professions in him. You need to stand on his word. You need to walk in this earth and act like you know that he is Yah. You need to walk in this earth and act like you know that he is going to bring it to pass. You need to go into that office and know that you're the head and not the tail. You need to go into that office and know that before you may have been last, but now you're first. You really need to realize who you are in Yah and then manifest it. You can't just say it. A lot of people are saying, I know who I am and I know who he is and I know what I possess and I know what I have in benefits, but you don't manifest it. And it's time to demand a manifestation. It's time to command a manifestation of his word and his truth in your life. It's time for you to pick yourself up and gather yourself and cast the enemy down under your feet and move forward. Listen, defeat is not something that cancels out your success, but if you find yourself in a place of defeat, if you find yourself not successful in the area, then you need to go to the Most High and ask Him, show me and direct me in the direction that I need to go in to be successful. Show me where I missed the mark. Don't complain. Don't give up. Don't think. Don't allow failure to come in and cause you to be stagnant. But what you do is you let failure and you let defeat catapult you into success by giving you that fervor, giving you that oomph to keep moving. It make you kick and make that fight kick in. And that's what needs to happen. I think that a lot of people give up too soon. I think that a lot of people begin to murmur and complain, and they lose sight of the fact that the Most High is practical, and He processes us in and out. He processes us out of something to process us into something, or He may be processing us in something to be able to, and He's going to process us out of something, but we're going through a process. And when we realize that things in Him are a process, when we begin to process, listen, if He bought you to it, if He bought you in it, He's going to bring you out of it. And so when we realize that everything is a process and things begin to happen, when we need to begin to rejoice in Him. He said to rejoice in tribulation. What? Tribulation worketh patience. And then He tells us to let patience do her perfect work. And so when we find ourselves in trying situations, when we find ourselves struggling even to pray, struggling even to read the Word, just struggling because of life issues and things that happen in life, just begin to praise Him. Give Him a desperate praise. Give Him an anyhow praise. There are times when I said, Father, I don't like the way I'm feeling. I don't like what's going on in my life, but I'm going to give You an anyhow praise. Father, I need You to move on my behalf, so now I'm going to give You a desperate praise. Why do I do that? Because I know He inhabits the praises of Yisrael. He inhabits the praises of His people. We are His people. He lives in our praise. When you begin to praise Him, it makes Him come and see about you. When you begin to praise Him, He begins to live in the atmosphere of your praise. Do you hear what I'm saying? He begins to live in the atmosphere of your praise. So wherever you may be, it doesn't matter. You could be in your car. You could be at the grocery store. You could be at work. You could be at the hospital. Listen, you could even be in jail. When you begin to praise, y'all, He will show up and He will live and He will breathe in the midst of your praise. And when your praise gets to a point where it's really, really high, where it takes you into a place of worship, you know, that kind of praise that you start out being thankful for what He's done, and then you end up being thankful and grateful for who He is, and you find yourself weeping softly and just crying out to Him. You find yourself caught up in this place. This is when He takes your praise. He takes you out of your praise in your own sanctuary and bring you to the praise in His sanctuary, and He changes it from praise to worship. You hear me, Elder Gwendolyn Pope? He changes it from praise to worship. And in the midst of your worship, He comes up to you and He anoints you with Him, because you can't come into His presence and leave out the same way that you came in. Because when you go into His presence, part of that flesh, that carnality in you has to die. So then when He rubs Himself and anoints you with Himself, and you come out of that worship experience and you find yourself back in your sanctuary, back in your home, or the place that you were praising Him, you will not be the same. People will know that you've been in His presence. There is a glow upon the people of Yah that takes the time to go into the presence of Yah and allow Him to minister to them. I'm not talking about complaining. I'm talking about going into His presence. He begins to minister to you. You begin to worship Him. You receive what He has given to you. And when you come out looking more like Him. You come out like Moshe with a glow on your face because you were in the presence of the Most High Yah. Let's focus on what Yah is doing in the earth. And instead of complaining about what the enemy's doing, just bind them up and keep moving. Bind them up by faith according to the word of Yah. The word of Yah said, whatsoever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you loose on earth will be loose in heaven. Well, Dr. Janet, what does that mean? I hear that, but what does that really mean? It means whatever you prohibit in earth, He will prohibit it in the spirit realm where He's at. And whatever you permit in the earth, He will permit it in the spirit realm. So He's telling you, you have the power to prohibit and dictate what is going on in your atmosphere. He's telling you that you have the power, hallelujah, to control the atmosphere wherever you're at. You have the authority to do it also. You have the authority to do it. So be encouraged. Do you hear me? Be encouraged. Y'all bless you, Sister Vanessa Eubanks, Mother of Zion. Y'all bless you. Be encouraged. Be encouraged wherever you're at. You don't have to be in the building to praise him. Praise him in your home. Praise him in your vehicle. Praise him in your yard. Praise him. Let everything that have breath praise ye the Most High Yah. Because like I said, he lives and he breathes and he demonstrates and he moves in our praise. Listen, listen, listen. Yah never shows up as a partial Yah. He doesn't show up as a partial God or a partial Elohim. But Yah shows up as everything that he is and everything we need him to be at that time. So when he shows up, listen to me and listen to me very good. He shows up with everything that you need, but it's up to you to go and get it. It's up to you to receive it. How do you go and get it? You step into his presence. You don't resist him. You don't quench the Holy Spirit. You don't quench your praise. But what you do is you begin to receive from him. You begin to praise him. You begin to worship him. You begin to acknowledge the fact that he is there. Hallelujah. You begin to acknowledge the fact that you feel his presence. And after you finish giving him all the accolades, after you finish worshiping him, then make your supplications known unto him. Hallelujah. Make your supplications known unto him. Tell him what you need from him. He's there to meet your needs. You hear me, Teresa Sullivan? He's there to meet your needs. Yah is there to meet our needs. He wants to bless us. He wants to provide for us. He wants to deliver us. He wants to set us free. He wants to build us up. Hallelujah. He wants to heal us. He wants to perform miracles. Do you believe tonight? Do you believe tonight for him to do all of that for you? The scripture says, according to your faith, be it unto you. What are you believing tonight? What is your faith saying tonight about your relationship with Yah? What are you saying to him about who you know he is? The scripture says you have to first know he is and that he is a rewarder of them who diligently seek him. Well, what are you saying to him about who he is? Hallelujah. What are you believing? And who are you believing him to be? And what are you believing him for? The scripture says what's impossible for man is possible for him. The scripture says there's nothing too hard. He actually asked the prophet, is there anything too hard for me? And so tonight he's asking you about your situation. He's asking you about your prayer request. He's asking you about that fleece that you put out there to him. Is there anything too hard for me? Everything that is hard is easy for y'all. Everything that we think is hard to accomplish, hard to do, hard to imagine is so easy for y'all. And when we realize that, we will go with him with the expectation that he's going to do what they feel is impossible. He's going to make it possible. Will you allow him to make it possible through you? Hallelujah. Will you allow him to do it through you? Can you stop focusing on what the enemy is trying to do in your life? Because he's an easy win. He's an easy win. You know how I know the enemy is an easy win? Because the Most High said he's given us power over all the power of the enemy. So we already have the victory over the enemy through the infilling of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit. Spirit, the power, the Holy Spirit of Yah, the Ruach of Yah, the Spirit of Yah. We have power through him, and he has given us authority to use that power through Mashiach Yahawashah, Jesus Christ. Listen to what I'm saying to you tonight. Stop walking in this earth thinking that you don't have power and that you have to allow the enemy to do what he do, because you do have power. Blessings, Bishop Irv Sandler. Blessings, Prophetess Diane Newby, hallelujah. Glory to his evangelist, Diane Newby. Glory to his name. He's saying to you tonight, I have given you power, I have given you authority, and I have given you permission to be who I called you to be in this earth. And he expects us to bear fruit. Blessings to you, Sis Elizabeth Smith. He expects us to bear fruit. We can't be walking around like the man who had one talent. We can't be negligent. We cannot be missing in action. We cannot be AWOL. We cannot be slothful. We cannot be lazy. We got to get out there and reproduce the kingdom. We got to get out there and duplicate the kingdom. If you're called to the street ministry, get out in them streets and duplicate the kingdom. If you're called to the outreach ministry, get out there and evangelize and duplicate the kingdom. If you're called to go minister to the sick and shut in, go ahead and duplicate advocate the kingdom in the ministries of help. If you're called to preach the word, don't get up there and wonder if you're preaching what y'all are saying. Don't get up there and be afraid of people's faces. Don't get up there and be afraid to say what y'all are saying. But you get up there and you share the word and you do it and allow the Ruach HaKodesh to move through you and flow through you and set the captive free. It is time to stop giving the enemy credit that you should be giving to the Most High Yah. It is time to stop blaming the enemy for things that you have done in order for you to either get chastisement or you're reaping what you sow. But in all of it, if you're getting chastised or you're reaping what you sow, you can always repent as long as you got breath in your body. You can repent and get back on track and let the power of Yah shine forth through you so much so, and men see your good works and glorify Yah. Hallelujah. There's a big problem in the body now because people want people to see them. There's so many people who want to be seen versus Yah being seen. And so now they have become idols. And Yah is saying that he's bringing these idols down, whether they have big platforms or whether they got small platforms. The idols are coming down. The high groves are being knocked down. Hallelujah. And he's saying, I'm calling my people out of darkness. I'm calling my people out of the caves. I'm calling my people that are hiding under rocks and behind trees. I'm calling...
Shalom. We invite you to fellowship with us every Saturday at 1 p.m. at Yeshiva Worship International Fellowship Gathering at Yeshiva, 5808 Knightville Boulevard, Knightville, North Carolina.
You forth with a word, and I want you to prophesy to the dry bones. I want you to speak to your neighbor. Hallelujah. I want you to speak to the stranger in the grocery store. I want you to whisper to the stranger in the library. Hallelujah. I want you to do the work. I want you to breathe in those dry bones and cause them to mount up and be a mighty army in me. Everybody has a responsibility to share with y'all is saying. If he gave it to you, he's giving you that responsibility to share it. If he gave it to you, that means there's somebody in your vicinity, in your circle around him, that need to hear what he has told you in your quiet time, in your prayer time. And even if he just whispered in your spirit, there is somebody who needs to hear it. We have to stop holding back and allowing the enemy to put fear in us and tell us they're not going to receive you. You're wasting your time. If y'all spoke that thing in you, he has a determination and a desire for you to speak it into the lives of the people that you meet. Why? Because he's commanding you once again to breathe into the dry bones. Hallelujah. Yah is speaking to his people in uncommon places. But he's calling us to the marketplace ministry. He's calling us to leave those buildings, to go out into the highways, into the byways, and to make disciples of men. He's calling us to witness with wisdom on our jobs. He's calling us to witness with wisdom in the hospitals. He's calling us to witness with wisdom in the streets. He's calling us to witness. Why? Because there is somebody who said, Father, if you are real, have somebody come and witness to me. And then you walk past them and he say, I want you to tell them I love them. Many people just need to know that somebody cares about them. Many people just need to know that the Most High has heard their prayer. Many people just need to know that the Most High love them and that he has not forgotten about him and that he has not kicked them to the wayside, that he desires to be in relationship and fellowship with him and her. Many people need to know that. But how would they know except you open your mouth and speak it, because he uses people to bless people. He chose the foolishness of preaching to save his people. And so if he's telling us that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony, don't you understand that when we share our testimony of how we overcame, that people will begin to believe that they can overcome too because of the testimony? We are the record of the power of Yah being demonstrated in the earth. How would the people know that Yah is still answering prayers, that Yah is still healing bodies, that Yah is still delivering, that Yah is still putting families back together, that Yah is still restoring? How would we know? How would he know except, or she or they would know except we open our mouth and testify? So we got to stop sitting around having devilish conversations. We got to stop having complaining clubs. We got to stop sitting around talking about what the devil is doing 24/7, 365, all the time. All we talk about a lot of people. You talk to them, all they talk about is what the devil is doing. The devil is busy. Well, guess what? If the devil is busy, that means that y'all is even more busy. Are you listening to me tonight? If the devil is busy, that means that y'all is even more busy than him. And the difference between the devil, HaSatan, and y'all is that y'all is everywhere present and the enemy is not. Hallelujah. So he sees what you're going through, but he's already equipped you. Listen to what I'm saying to you tonight, my sisters and my brothers. I love you dearly. Listen to what I'm saying to you tonight. Anytime when you are sitting in the classroom and you go through training, do you hear me, chosen Israel? You're going through training. The teacher trained you. The teacher, the instructor instructs you and give you all the tools you need to pass the test. Then when it's time to take the test, they're sitting there and they're monitoring you, making sure that you don't cheat, making sure that you do what you're supposed to do properly in order to pass that test. That's what they're doing. Hallelujah. That's the same way that Yah is with us. He has equipped us with everything that we need to pass the test. And when the test comes, he is watching us to see if we are going to implement the tools that he has given us. He is so practical. He is so practical, Sister Liz. He is so practical. Yah is practical. We go through things. We go through issues. We go through situations. Hallelujah. 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 We go through them. And when we go through them, we forget that we are empowered to overcome them. We are empowered to conquer them. And when we remember that we are empowered to conquer them, and just when the enemy thinks that he has us, the Most High will breathe a second wind in us. He will quote scripture that will strengthen us and cause us to stand up and take a hold of the enemy and defeat him and put him where he's supposed to be, under our feet. What did Mashiach say? He said, get thee behind me. You know what he was really saying, y'all? He was saying, get out of my face. Sometimes we need to tell the enemy to get out of our face, especially in people that he used. Get out of my face. Get thee behind me. You will not distract me from what is in front of me in the kingdom of Yah. You will not distract me or detour me from my path. We need to learn how to look past what the enemy is doing. We need to learn how to look past and see what Yah is doing in the earth on our behalf and on behalf of his people. Do I have a witness here today? Do I have a witness here today that we need to realign our sights on Yah and stop looking at all the negativity around us? Calibrate our hearing and stop listening to all the negativity around us. People are going to talk about you. People are going to betray you. People are going to do things to you. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. Yah let us know that it's going to happen. Do you hear me, Elder Pope? It's going to happen. But what are you going to do when it happens in order to keep you focused on what you're supposed to do? Listen, people say, I've been fighting warfare all day long. And I said, well, did you win? I mean, did the warfare stop? Because listen, did you complete your assignment? Well, no, I've been fighting warfare. I couldn't complete my assignment because I was focusing on the warfare. And I say to them, listen, effective warfare is fighting the battle and completing your assignment. The reason why you're going through warfare is because the enemy don't want you to complete your assignment. So effective warfare is the fact that you completed your assignment, not that you got distracted by the attack, not that you got distracted by who was doing the attack, but you completed your assignment. That is the success in spiritual warfare. Do you hear what Yah is saying to his people tonight? He said, focus on me. Focus on me. Learn of me. When you learn of him, it doesn't matter. Hear what I'm saying. I know we go through different things in our life and things hurt, and sometimes we get a tad bit distracted. But when we realize that our life is hidden in Messiah, when you realize that you're connected and you are filled with the one who will not allow you to fail, you are filled with the one that's going to give you the victory, you are filled with the one that's going to cause you to overcome, you are filled with the one who's already defeated the enemy and then gave us that same power to defeat him in these natural bodies. When you begin to realize that and things happen, you begin to realize it rain on the just as well as unjust. You begin to realize that such is in life. And instead of complaining, instead of talking about the devil is doing this, ooh, the devil is busy. You need to start praising Yah, because guess what? The only way that the enemy knows that he has gotten to you is because of what he hears you say. Not because, hallelujah, not because he attacked you and I got to them, but it's what you say that make the enemy know, hallelujah, that he has gotten to you. So you need, in the time that the enemy is attacking, that's when you need to praise the most. Because your praise will confuse him, just like Judah confused the enemy up in Mount Seir when they were coming against him, the Ammonites, the Moabites up in Mount Seir. What did Judah do? What did the children of Israel do? They sent Judah first. And Judah began to say, praise y'all, his mercy endures forever. And they began to send praise before them. And what that praise did is by confusement, and it confused the enemy to the point where the enemy began to fight each other and kill each other. And when they finished killing each other, they killed themselves. Do you hear me tonight, people of Yah? Praise the Most High so much so in the midst of the storm, in the midst of the attack, until the very vessels that the enemy is using, you'll look and you'll see them arguing with each other. The very attack will turn back on the attacker. And I'm not saying this as if to say that's what they get. I'm telling you according to the scripture. According to the scripture, hallelujah, Most High desires for us to gain and not to lose, hallelujah. Most High desires for us to recover all that we lost in those seasons that we didn't know any better. He desires for us to recover those things that we lost in the season that we didn't realize that we had the right to take it back, that we had a right to get our stuff back, that we had a right to recover what was rightfully ours. And he gave us permission to pursue, for we shall recover all without fail. The problem is that we were too afraid to pursue. The problem is that we were wondering if we had a right to do it. The problem is we felt so low about what was going on in our life until we felt like we deserved it. And I'm telling you tonight that the Most High said, your stuff, he's restoring your stuff. This is a season of restoration. He's restoring physical things. He's restoring relationships. He's restoring spiritual things. This is a season of restoration. He said, I am Yah, your Allah, and I shall restore. Do you hear what he's saying? Do you hear what he's saying? Focus on the one who can make you whole again. Focus on the one who can give you back your stuff. Focus on the one who will empower you to be able to take back that he don't give back is what he expects for you to take back. Hallelujah. Listen, according to the scripture, he said he will restore the years the cankerworm, the palmerworm, the caterpillar, and the locust has eaten. That's what he's going to restore. But then the word also tells you to pursue, for you shall recover all without fail, or without fail, you shall recover all. That's what you got to go and take. Now, he's going to restore those years that was eaten, but those locusts, but he's telling you there's some stuff that you got to go get yourself. There's some stuff that you got to stop saying, can you please give me this back? Can you please give me that back? And he said, there's some stuff that you got to go into the spirit realm first and get it back, take it back, and watch it be manifested in the natural. People have taken and stolen your self-esteem. You hear me? People have stolen your confidence. People have stolen your ideas. People have stolen just different things from you. And the Most High said, if I gave you that idea, even though they may be successful in it, I meant for you to be successful in it too. You go and you implement that idea. You have shared with them things about businesses, and they went out and they started a business on your vision. Now it's time for you to implement that vision. Take your vision back and work it. Take your family back. Hallelujah. People have come in and divided your family, and it's time for you to go to the Most High and ask him to restore your family, and then believe that he will do it. Hallelujah. Expect him to do it. Hallelujah. Every corner that you turn, have an expectation that your family is going to be restored. Do you hear what he's saying? You know what you need y'all to do in your life. And it's up to you to allow him to do it. And it's up to you when he tells you to go get your stuff back to do it, to walk in the direction of restoration. You got to stop allowing people to come in your life and continuously. All they got to talk about is negativity. All they got to talk about is somebody else's business. All they got to talk about is gossip. All they got to talk about is what the devil, Satan, is doing. It's time for you to shut up those voices. It's time for you to calm and quiet those voices and begin to draw to you voices of like mind that's going to talk about how great Yah is, that's going to talk about the power of Yah, that's going to talk about the ability of Yah, that's going to talk about the authority of Yah, that's going to talk about the awesomeness and the magnificence of Yah, that's going to talk about the power and the demonstration of Yah. Hallelujah. Those people who are constantly praying, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. These are the people that you need around you. And those who are upset about the fact that you don't want to sit down and be a part of their pity party, let them know you're not coming and you're not bringing any gifts or food or anything to drink to make them comfortable in the midst of their pity party. And sometimes a word of encouragement start with a word of rebuke. Hallelujah. Get up out of them sackcloths and ashes. You sitting around like a man or a woman that has no hope. Either Yah is Yah or he's not. Listen, David showed us in Psalms 43 how you can be going through things, but then all of a sudden your Holy Spirit kick in and say, be still my soul, or be still. Why are you so in so much despair? Oh, my soul, I will make my boast. I will praise my Yah, for he is the one who saves my face. You hear what I'm saying? Because we need to realign our thoughts. We need to realign our vision. We need to realign our hearing. We need to realign and line up with the things of Yah, what the word of Yah says, versus us crying out like mere human beings, thinking that and feeling like we don't have any hope. We do have hope. And who is it? It's Mashiach Yahawashah, our only hope of glory. He is our hope of glory. Hallelujah. And if you have him, if you're filled, if you made him your master and your Messiah, then you got benefits. You hear me? You got benefits, baby. You got benefits. Hallelujah. And those benefits do not expire. Some people don't use them. They lay dormant. But if you start walking in them benefits, you start using them benefits, you're going to see that Yah will work, and who will let him? You're going to see that he will work. You will see that those benefits are powerful. You will see that you are covered. Hallelujah. I said it the other night. You are covered. Hallelujah. People be driving their vehicles and they don't have insurance. They get arrested by the authority. But listen, you got your vehicle. You out there, you walking, you living this life. You got insurance in the Most High. And it does not expire. Hallelujah. It does not expire. You are covered in the Most High. Our lives are hidden in Messiah Yahawashah. We have benefits. Yeah. I want to remind you tonight. I want to remind you, whatever a man thinks, that's what he is. I'm telling you, out the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So you need to fill your heart with the word of Yah. You need to fill your heart with praise and worship. You will find yourself praising him in the midst of the storm. Hallelujah. You'll begin to praise. You'll begin to worship him. You'll begin to exalt him and lift him up. And while everybody is fretting over the situation, you'll find yourself rejoicing in the midst of the situation. You'll find yourself in the eye of the storm where the greatest peace is. Hallelujah. You'll find yourself in a place of safety. You'll find yourself in his chambers. Do you hear me? I hope you hear me tonight, what God is saying to me to say to you all tonight. Because too many people are complaining. Too many people are asking people to pray for them while they're not praying for themselves. Too many people are coming to people saying, I'm asking you to pray because I know he hears your prayers. Well, I got a newsflash for you, brother. I got a newsflash for you, sister. He hears your prayers as well. And it's time for you to open your mouth and begin to pray. And it's time for you to trust and believe that he is going to move on your prayers. We got to be in you. How can you go and pray for somebody else and expect the Most High to move, and you can't pray and you can't trust him or have faith in him to move for you? You better start believing. You better start believing. All unbelief is sin. Did you hear me? All unbelief is sin. All unbelief is sin. Yah is shifting us to a place in him where we are going to be walking in absolute faith. He is shifting us in a place in him, to a place in him where we're not going to be speaking of him. We're going to be speaking as him. As soon as he, how do you speak as Yah in the earth? When he speaks to you, you speak because you are a representative of him. You are an ambassador of the Messiah. So when he speak and you speak, you're speaking as him. And when you speak what he is speaking, he got to bring it to pass. Hallelujah. He has to bring it to pass. Bless his wonderful name. So he's calling us to a higher place of relationship with him. He's calling us to a deeper place of worship and consecration in him. He's calling us to a stronger faith in him, a stronger believing in him. He's calling us to that place, to a deeper relationship in him. Hallelujah. He wants us to be able to hear his voice in the midst of the most loudest storms in our life. We got to be able to hear his voice. He wants us to be able to see him in the midst of the strong.
Join Dr. Janet L. Noel of Gathering at Yeshiva Worship every Friday night at 8 p.m. on the Winning in Prayer TV network, located on Roku TV or on the Facebook page, Winning in Prayer TV.
Longest, deepest storm, he wants us to be able to see him moving in the midst of that storm. And the only way you can do that is to stay focused on him and stay focused on the word that he spoke over your life. Are you with me tonight? Are you with me tonight? I had not intended on coming on and ministering a word from Yah, but then when he put it in my spirit to minister, we were doing an interview and there was such a large echo. The Holy Spirit said, cancel and reschedule this speaker, this interview. So I canceled it, and he knew why, because you all needed to hear this. You all needed to be encouraged right where you're at. You all needed to know that the Most High sees and he hears and he is moving on your behalf. Just be still and know that he is Yah. Be still that he and know that he is moving on your behalf. He wants you to hold your peace and allow him to fight your battle. Many of you are in battles and you don't know how to hold your peace. You don't know what to do, and let the Most High fight your battle. Position yourself and posture yourself in a position in a way where you don't respond, act, or react to what they are doing to you. You only obey the instructions that Yah is giving you concerning how he wants you to respond to what they're doing. And most of the time, not all of the time, most of the time he would just say, be still and know that I'm Yah. And then there are times when he say, confront the issue. And when he tells you to confront the issue, he'll show you exactly what to do. Hallelujah. Yah is speaking through you just like he's speaking through your pastor. Yah is speaking through you just like he's speaking through the prophet. Yah is speaking through. Now, I'm not saying you're a pastor or a prophet. No, but I'm saying to you, there, no one has a monopoly on who Yah can use. No one has a monopoly on who Yah can talk to. No one has a monopoly on who Yah can use and speak through and encourage someone. So I'm saying to you, stop saying, well, I can't talk to them. I can't encourage them because I'm not a leader and they're a leader. Do you know a lot of times leaders are encouraged by people who don't have titles because, hallelujah, they're not afraid to come to them and share the encouraging word. And sometimes the ones who have the titles are the ones that need to be quiet and sit down because they're operating in sin. They're operating in error. They don't read the word. They're not in relationship with y'all. They're in relationship with their title. They're in relationship with their identity of being a preacher. They're in relationship with the popularity of them possessing that title, but they really don't have the light that they need to have in that candle in order for them to be called wise virgins. And they're walking around like a bunch of foolish virgins, leading people astray, leading people into ditches because they're blind. So I'm saying to you, you don't have to have a title for y'all to use you. Am I talking to somebody tonight? Most High is not going to let you into the kingdom based on your title. You're going into the kingdom based on your yes, based on your relationship, based on your yielding and your surrendering to him. Hallelujah. If you know Yah is speaking to you and you are making a covenant with him that you're going to come up to where he wants you to be, that you're going to get elevated in your mind concerning him, and you're not going to allow the enemy to keep you in low places where you can't hear or see, hallelujah, you can't move in Yah because you're so bound down by the spirit of heaviness and the powers of darkness. When he told you, I gave you authority over those entities, he gave us authority over the principalities, he gave us authority over the power powers and the dominions and the thrones. He gave us authority over the fallen angels. You hear me? He's given us authority over the kingdom of darkness. Will you use that authority by faith and not in fear, not doubting and hoping that it worked, but when you speak it, you expect it to work? Will you begin to speak to those situations? Will you begin to speak to those mindsets that the enemy is trying to send to you? He's the prince of the air and he's sending thoughts to you. Will you begin to cast those thoughts down and not entertain them anymore? You are somebody in Yah. You are somebody to him. He has need of you. He has use of you. And even though people will act like they don't believe what you're saying, they don't hear or receive what you're saying, listen, Most High called you. He sent you. Now let's get up. Let's go and let him use you in this season and in this time in your life. Amen. It's time. Somebody say it's time. Somebody say, it's time for me to come up. It's time for me to stand up. It's time for me to speak up. It's time for me to stand against the enemy. It's time for me to bind up the enemy. It's time for me to halt the kingdom of darkness. It's time for me to wreck the kingdom of Satan. It's time for me to take and possess my enemy's gates. Is there somebody in here that's taking this and know that the Most High is talking to them? It's time to possess the gates of your enemies. It's time to take authority over the atmosphere. It's time to take authority over your situation. It is time. Hallelujah. And the thing about it, men and women of Yah, you don't have to wait for the power to come on you, because the power lives inside of you. But ye shall receive power after that the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, has come upon you. It's time for you to go out and make witnesses in the earth. Amen. Am I talking to you tonight? Hallelujah. You have a purpose. You have a call. He has an intent for your life. That's the reason why he created you. Before he formed you in your mother's belly, he knew you. What does that mean? He's saying to you tonight, the reason why I put you in the earth, the reason why I put you in your mother's belly, is because of the purpose I had for you. It's because of what I created you for. I didn't create you and then give you a purpose. I created you because of the purpose I had for you to be in the earth. So listen to what he's saying, Bishop Moses. I created you for the purpose, not just with purpose. And I created you on purpose. Why did you create me, Yah? For a purpose. I needed someone to go into the streets and declare my word. And I said, well, let me create Bishop Moses. Let me create Pastor Dunlap, Clifforette. Let me create Chosen Israel. Let me create Kim Odom. Let me create Elder Pope. I'm going to create them to do this. And then he spoke your name in your mama's belly. And there you were. You were manifested on purpose, with a purpose. Because of your purpose. You were born because of your purpose. Do you hear what he's saying to you tonight? And it's time. So I speak into those dry areas of your life and I command you to come alive in the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach. I command you to get a second wind. I command you to be refreshed in the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach. I command you to be strengthened in the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach. I command you to be built up. I command you to remember who Yah is. I command you to remember who you are. I command you to remember your identity. I command you to remember your purpose. I command you to remember the agenda and the intent that Yah has for you. I command it in the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach tonight. I command the stirring up to begin all over again. Hallelujah. I command it. I command it in the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach, and it is so. Hallelujah. I command it. I command your language to change. I command your desires and your appetite to change and change for only the things of Yah. Hallelujah. I command you to speak the same heavenly language or the same language of heaven. You hear me? I command you to speak the same language that Yah is speaking concerning your life. Meaning, I command you to speak what he's saying. Hallelujah. No matter what the situation looks like, I command you to speak kingdom language. Hallelujah. Woo, glory to his name. Kingdom language. And I'm not talking about speaking in tongue, but I'm talking about speaking the language of the kingdom, the language of victory, the language of overcoming, the language of conquering what is trying to conquer you from the kingdom of darkness. I command you to speak the kingdom language in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. 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 Remember who you are tonight. Remember how he made you fearfully and wonderfully. Remember how he made you fearfully and wonderfully. Remember, hallelujah, that he made you a little lower than the angels. Remember, the question was, what is man that thou art mindful of him? Remember, he is mindful of you. Not just your sister, not just your brother, not just that preacher, not just that prophet, not just that evangelist, pastor, or teacher, that apostle, that bishop, that elder, but he is mindful of you. You are on his mind. Hallelujah. And bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Now get up. Get up and tell the world, tell the atmosphere, I belong to Yah. Hallelujah. And nothing and no one, no seed, no fruit that come from my body will be lost. I decree that. Hallelujah. I decree that I have the mind of my Messiah, Yahusha. I command my mind, hallelujah, to be transformed. I command my mind to be renewed. Begin to speak those things over you, not just your friend, not just your neighbor, not just that one who asked you to pray. Speak it over you and then expect it to happen. Tell the Most High, I want to have new encounters with you every single day. I don't ever want to forget not one encounter, small or great, that, hey, hallelujah, that I, hey, Gloria, that I've had with you. Give me new encounters with you, Yah, every single day. Allow me to encounter your presence. Allow me to encounter your might. Allow me to encounter your manifestation. Allow me to encounter your authority, hallelujah, your demonstration. Allow me to encounter conversations with you. Allow me to encounter your voice, your presence. Allow me to encounter you, Yah, every single day of my life. Make it happen, Father. I desire, I want to have an encounter with you. Hallelujah. I pray that I bless you tonight. I pray that I bless someone, encourage someone, provoke someone to good works tonight. I pray that I provoke somebody to get up and continue to move forward in him, in the Most High Yah. I pray that I encourage somebody to restore their focus in him and restore and rededicate their lives to the Most High Yah. If that's you and you're saying, Father, I know I belong to you, but I've been slacking and I need to rededicate my life and my time to you. Don't be ashamed. We're going to pray for you tonight. Hallelujah. We're going to pray for rededication. We're going to pray for strength. We're going to pray for restoration. You want to be rededicated? You want to be refreshed, you want to be restored, you want to be built up in Yah, you want to have encounters in him, don't hesitate. It doesn't matter what rank you are in the church in the eyes of man. It doesn't matter what your title is. It doesn't matter what your position is. We all need a refreshing in Yah. We all need to be refreshed from time to time. We all need to refocus from time to time. We all need to be restored. Is there another that desires prayer for them to be restored? Hallelujah. I'm telling you, we're going to pray in faith and we're going to stand in agreement with one another. And even while I'm praying, if you decide this is what I want from y'all too, if you decide you want a fresh refilling, you decide that you want to be refreshed in heaven, and we will pray for you too. I pray that everyone who's coming benefits off the grace on my life tonight, benefits off the anointing that's been released in this place, benefits off the words that has been released in this place, that they benefit off of it just because they were obedient to come in when they were pulled on and tugged on by the Holy Spirit to come into this place. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Watch and expect the manifestation of the Most High to come to pass. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I praise the Most High for all of you who have come in and those who have come in and left out to receive the word of Yah. I praise the Most High for those who have come to partake of the grace, the favor, the anointing that He has released in this place as destroying yokes of bondage, even as I speak by faith. I just believe it, and I just believe Yah. I just believe His word. I speak healing in many of your spirits. I speak healing in many of your souls. Many of you have been hurt by people emotionally, and I speak healing in your emotions. I decree that your soul, that He restores your soul tonight, and that you can forgive and just move on and move on in life and begin to grow even more in the Most High, Yah. It's time to let go. It's time to let go of odds. It's time to let go of things that people have done to you that would cause you not to forgive them, because it's only holding you back. It's time to move forward, and it's time to go up in Him. So you all have a blessed evening, and once again I thank you for tuning in and chiming in tonight just to receive of Yah. I thank you for hearing the word, and now I'm just expecting some praise reports. As the praise reports come forth, please, please, please begin to share with the people what Yah has done for you. Begin to share what Yah has done for you because of your obedience. Begin to share how He's answering your prayers and how He's using you. Amen. Praise Yah, because He is good. In the name of Yahawashah HaMashiach, glory to His name. He is so good. He is so good. Some of you call Him Jesus Christ. I call Him Yahawashah HaMashiach. Most High knows who we're calling on. He knows the reputation. Hallelujah. And we thank Him. Hallelujah. So we're expecting Him. We're expecting the Most High to move in the name of His Son, Yeshua HaMashiach, Yahawashah HaMashiach. We are expecting Him to for His name's sake, to do it. Amen. Do I have anybody that's standing in agreement with me? Do I have anyone who is standing on His promises tonight with me? Amen. You all be blessed. Glory to His name. You all have a blessed evening. Hallelujah. Continue to move in power and demonstration of the Holy Spirit, and continue practice. Sometimes you have to practice changing your language. Sometimes you have to practice changing how you converse. Sometimes you have to practice. So I'm going to leave this with you. I'm telling you, it's time for you to practice speaking what Yah is saying versus what the enemy is trying to put in your spirit, or the doubt, or the unbelief, or the confusion. Begin to speak what Yah is saying. Practice speaking what Yah is saying in these times and in these hours in your life until it become a lifestyle. We don't just want it to be a habit. We want it to be a lifestyle. So start speaking, practice speaking. Somebody come to you with negativity, you come back with something positive in the word of Yah. You come back with something positive that Yah has done. You come back with something positive that Yah is doing, just to make them know that Yah is still moving. He's still working in the earth, and we need to start focusing more on what Yah is doing and less on what the enemy is trying to do. Because guess what? Yah is all powerful. That means He's more powerful than the enemy, and He has all power. And so we bless Him tonight. You all have a blessed evening. And once again, y'all be glorified in all that you say and do. Shalom, shalom.